there are certain things about ICD-10-CM that you need to be aware of so that you can assist your physician as the transition happens, to say, you know, hey, this wasn't on your radar before, but ICD-10 has this now, and so therefore, you know, we need to change the documentation so that, you know, if you're aware of it. And one of those things is drug underdosing. This isn't in ICD-9. But it is an ICD-10. So what is drug underdosing? Underdosing is it's a new code. It identifies situations in which a patient has taken less of a medication than prescribed by the physician. Now, in ICD-9, you know, you have a code for if a patient intentionally took too much of his medication, or if a patient wasn't paying attention, wasn't coherent, and, you know, like took a pill when they got up in the morning and then forgotten 2 hours later, took another one, and then the afternoon after lunch took it. You know, there's codes to describe all of that. But this is one that says the patient is not taking the prescribed dose. He's taking less. Okay, now, it really works just like your poison codes. Okay, so if you're familiar with how that works, you can follow those steps. And mind you, the Blitz has a fantastic description of how to handle that. The medical condition is sequenced first. Okay, so what happened? And I gave an example here as a gentleman who has a seizure. Okay, the underdosing code is listed as a secondary diagnosis. The additional code explains why the patient's not taking the medication. This has never been available to us before. You know, not only could you not say, well, he's just not taking his medicine. You know, how do you document that? Well, why is he not taking his medicine? Well, he forgets. Well, that would deal with, you know, geriatric and give a you know, reasons why maybe they need home health or interventions or financial reasons.
Yeah, that's,
you know,
a big
this
case.
Is a Yeah, really big. So as we look down here, I wrote this these codes down. We've got R56.9 and T42. The letter O, X6A, Z91.120. Now, when I had done this before, obviously I made a mistake because I did a strike through on the letter O. This is a perfect example of when you're doing this new and first getting used to it. You want your letter O to have a definition between that and the zero. Okay, so Mr. Green had a seizure due to taking his Keppra. Taking his Keppra every other day to save money instead of every day. Now, my son takes Keppra. Luckily, we have insurance, but when I found out how much we would have had to pay, we're talking almost $500 a month if we didn't have insurance. So you can imagine if somebody was on Keppra and they had epilepsy or seizures, why they would be hesitant to pay the $500 a month. Okay, so we look at these codes. Let's break it down. We have the R56.9 unspecified convulsion. So Mr. Green had a convulsion, all right? Now, the T code here is poisoning by adverse effect of and underdosing of an anti-epileptic sedative. Now, there's other descriptions in this drug type, hypnotic and anti-Parkinsonism drug, underdosing of hydination. No, say that word, Lorraine. Hydatonin.
Yeah, hydatonin. Where is it?
You know, go up. Scroll back up.
Oh.
You went down too far. Underdosing of HY. Yeah, that word right there. How would you say that?
Hydatonin.
Yeah. Anyway, it's obviously a medication. I mean, that's the derivative. Like if you said an opiate or something like that. Derivative initial encounter. Okay, so this is the first treatment Again, we can do that in ICD-10 that we couldn't do in ICD-9. Mr. Green had a convulsion. Why did he have a convulsion? He wasn't taking his Keppra. Why wasn't he take? Or he wasn't taking his Keppra correctly. Why wasn't he taking his Keppra correctly? Because he couldn't afford it. That right there. Now don't forget, and I'm always reminding people that why do we code? We code for statistic purposes, as well as to get paid. But our number one reason for coding is for statistics. What does that tell you? This will be able to tell you how many people are non-compliant with their medications because they can't afford them. We've never been able to do that. And we've been able to track initial encounters now. So when you get to this Z91.1, that tells you in your code book to code first under dosing of medication. It gives you a range. Okay, so there again, it's telling you the sequencing if you're worried about it. Now, this tells you how to find that code. I wanted to break this down to let you see how to do it. Z91, personal risk factors not elsewhere classified. Okay, so personal risk factor is how you're going to find this in the index. So the Z91.1, taking it to the next step, patient's noncompliance with medical treatment and regime. Now, this can mean they're just not taking it. This can mean they're taking it improperly. There's several reasons to be noncompliant. Okay, Z91.12, patient's intentional underdosing of medication regime. Now, we've had intentional overdosing, you know, like they took the whole bottle, but we've never had underdosing before.
Right.
And Z91.120, patients' intentional underdosing of medication regime due to what? Financial hardships. And there's more than one thing there, because there's the 0.128, patient intentional underdosing of medication regime for other reason. And maybe there's another reason. Maybe he intentionally doesn't take it, which Keppra really has no side effects. But let's say it's a medication and it hurts his stomach. So instead of calling the doctor and telling him, you know, man, I'm really getting these stomach cramps when I take this medication, he just takes it less or cuts it in half or, you know, whatever reason. But now we have a way to track that. And I think, is that the end? At the bottom
yep.
of this? Oh, okay. So, again, ICD-10, amazing. It's going to help us statistically with our statistics in the U.S., which other countries have been doing this for years, and it's going to help us give a better care, because if you know that your patient is not taking their medication because they can't afford it, well, it's documented, so we're going to go find another medication, or we're going to get the social people in there to help them mm-hmm. and let them know what their services are. They're going to get better care. So this is real exciting. I really enjoyed this question.
Yeah, see how she gets about ICD-9?
Ah!
Or ICD, I should say. 9, 10, 11, 12.
Anything. Diagnosis.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.